Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Reunion Arena and to World Class Championship Wrestling. As tonight we celebrate Thanksgiving with the second annual Thanksgiving Turkey Day Spectacular. This bout, ladies and gentlemen, one fall, 15-minute time limit. Presented by General Akbar, the boss of Devastation Incorporated from Points Unknown. 245 pounds, the missing link. And across the ring, his opponent from the islands of Hawaii at 235 pounds, Buck Rock and Roll Zuma. Rick Hazard, your referee.
And welcome to World Class Championship Wrestling, the Thanksgiving holiday superstars here. And it's great to have you along as the missing link and Rock and Roll Zumhoff started out, and the link starts it in a hurry. Before the bell, before Zumhoff is ready to get after, oh, there it is. Try to get out of his lovely attire. Zumhoff caught, but he is giving the missing man a lot to think about, if he can think about it. Good leg, and here goes the link. And Zumhoff rocking and rolling, trying to get it going here in the opening moments of this fantastic card on World Class Championship Wrestling. The link, oh, with a flying spear called his head. That battering ram that the Romans could have used well. The missing link again with a battering ram of the head. And see the link so well clothed in his armor. No, he wouldn't need a spear or a sword, just strike somebody with that head. Coming up and somehow flat on his back, battered again by the missing link. Boy, this is a tremendous, tremendous time of World Class Championship Wrestling. Coming up next, the Texas Death Match with Gordy and Khan. They got Mike Von Erich and Gino Hernandez, Kerry Von Erich, the Iceman, I guess Jake, the Snake, and Kaniski. All this from Reunion Arena in downtown Dallas, Texas, a gorgeous, gorgeous building. And the link comes up again, tries to put him down for a pin. One, two, and does it! The missing link. Coming through where Desert Devastation Incorporated and Skander Akbar, who makes his appearance in the ring. And here's Mark Lorenz.
1 minute, 37 seconds. Winner of the battle is the missing link.
So the link has devastated Buck Rock and Roll Zumhoff. And we'll be back with more excitement on World Class Championship Wrestling in just a moment. And on the mat are the remains of Stella May's hair that Nicola Roberts cut just recently. Oh, look out, we got a scissor out there right now. And Stella May is ready to, well, both of them have had scissors. This could be pretty dangerous. And I don't think Stella May wants to give up the scissors. Nicola's standing where she dropped. David Manning wants the scissors. And
don't let them have these.
David Manning telling us not to let them have the scissors. Well, hopefully that won't be a chore down here for Mark Lorenz. As Nicola Andrea, the Lady Giant, drops all of her leather accoutrements, accessories. These two, of course, battling long ago against, really through Gino Hernandez. As Stella May made it her personal vendetta to take care of Gino Hernandez because of the treatment that Sunshine had had. And then along came Andrea. And Andrea became the bodyguard. And she is a, well, I see Gino calls her Andrea the Lady Giant. So here we go with the two women in action. Andrea, the Lady Giant, Nicola Roberts, pounding into the midsection of Stella May, and Stella May's got it outside the rope from Sunshine Applause. Estella Bay. A lady who can handle an 18-wheeler, and right now is handling Nicola Roberts. And here comes Gino out. Gino in tuxedo, talking to his own bodyguard as Sunshine watches from across the ring. And the count is on Nicola Roberts. And she has to come back in. Stellaway helps her right back in, and Stellaway is hammering Stellaway. Now with a choke, and Nicola is pulled out of the ring by Gino Hernandez. So Gino trying to give his protege some encouragement, some coaching. As Sunshine watches the action. And now here comes Mike Butter. And Mike will be over. Mike will be over with Sunshine. So that's all even up now. In a way, actually, Stella May has a little more help in her corner. And here comes Nicola Roberts, banging on the back of Stella May. And Gino's animated now, as Nicola has a chance to really take advantage of Stella May. These two women who have collided through Gino Hernandez and through others, Chris Adams. And Andrea, the Lady Giant, pounding on Stella May, and a worried Sunshine. Sunshine, there goes Stella May into the corner, banged into the corner post. And Sunshine is really in anguish now. Expression of sorrow and sickness and sadness on Sunshine's face. As Stella May is hammered into the corner buckle. Great move by Stella May French. And Gino Hernandez grabbing Stella May's legs, and here comes Mike Butter to take Gino in tow as the two women battle up in. A body slam by Nicola. Sunshine spraying in the Andrews face. Stella May, one, two, three. Sunshine sprayed something in the eyes of Nicola Roberts. She fell back over, and Stella May is the winner. Mike Von Erich in. And Mike and Gino go at it. And Nicola Roberts, oh, look out. Sunshine has the scissors. Sunshine has the scissors. And they may try to shear Nicola Roberts. Here comes Gino in. There's Mike Von Erich. Oh, now Sunshine. And now Gino's taking them behind. And they're going to cut Gino's hair. They're going to try. Nicola's escaped. Gino's escaped. And they couldn't use the scissors on the hair of Gino or Nicola. But the winner is Stella May French with a little help. With a little help from Sunshine. Well, that's why she came, to help Burnett. And she followed through and certainly was a deciding factor in the victory of Stella May French over Nicola Roberts. And we'll be back with more World Class Championship Wrestling. There are the victors in just a moment. Skander Akbar is in the ring with Killer Khan. But it's not Khan who's going to be involved in the official bout. It is Skander Akbar, the man, the general. And the reason for that bout is Chick Donovan, who, as you may recall, last year spent a long time in the hospital because Killer Khan almost destroyed his left knee. And Chick Donovan claims that it was Skander Akbar who sent Khan to hurt him, that it really wasn't Khan who thought that up. And he wanted this bout with Skander to get even. And let's go to Mark Lorentz in the ring.
One fall, 30-minute time limit, special revenge challenge bout. Hitting first in front of me, known as the General, the boss of Devastation Incorporated, hailing from Egypt at 240 pounds, General Skander Akbar. And his opponent requesting the special challenge bout, returning to Reunion Arena from Santa Monica, California, 240 pounds, the Golden Boy, Chick Donovan. Bronco Lubitsch, your referee.
And so we have the special event. Chick Donovan warning Skander Akbar. Now, Skander's a very, very strong man. And away we go, the bell rang. And so did Chick Donovan, rang a rat-a-tat-tat right on the head of Skander Akbar, and this bout is underway. Donovan with a heavy, well, not a heavy brace, but a good athletic brace on his left knee. Going after Skander Akbar, a man from Egypt, Devastation Incorporated's leader. Chick Donovan coming back and wanting to come back with Skander Akbar. And he got the man by the beard right now, right by his chinny chin chin. And choking him right above his ear. We mentioned that the Midnight Express, a new group, is coming in. Another astounding man, a newcomer called Rip Crippler Oliver. And he gets the nickname because he's probably crippled more men in professional wrestling than any other person. And so Rip Oliver, the Crippler, is coming in. Boy, excitement with Midnight Express and Oliver. Right now, Chick Donovan and Skander Akbar. Boy, a lot of folks would like to be in Chick Donovan's place. I think of the Von Erichs and Terry Gordy. A hammer, and Donovan gets ripped across the eye. Well, Donovan had a full knee operation. That was really a major repair effort on the part of the doctors. And it's a credit to medical profession that he is back and working with that knee in just about 6 months. And there he is. Now right now, Skander Akbar is taking charge. Oh, a shot on that left leg. And that's got to hurt. Rehabilitation time is over, but you know, it takes a long time for the soreness to go out of it. Oh, right down on that knee again. Not on that knee again.
No.
So Chick Donovan has that knee put in jeopardy again, and here is Skander Akbar ripping on it. So Skander looks like he knows the weakest point of Donovan, and he's going after him. Well, that's the danger of the athlete and the professional wrestler. And in this case, the athlete, has had a bad left knee, and Donovan needs to rip Akbar out of there if he can. Not back on that bottom rope again. And a ripping and twisting and turning on it. And Bronco Lubitsch warning Skander to get off that knee. But it hasn't helped any, and Skander Akbar knows the weakest point of a defense for Donovan. Just like any general would know. Donovan maneuvering. Now he goes to work on a knee. Now it's Donovan's turn to take a knee apart. Donovan crashing on Skanderak Barr. Donovan flipping it back. And now Skanderak Barr getting what he thinks, as Donovan thinks he deserves, a work on his left knee. And a bar him and cross him. And rip, and Akbar is in agony as Donovan rolls it back and rolls it back. Skander. The head of Devastation Incorporated with a missing link in Killer Khan. And two of the most despicable characters probably around. Now a rip in the eyes, and that gets Donovan's attention, and Skander has a chance to come back. The Fantastic just defending their American Tag Team Championship. And Akbar roll on his head. You know, the six-man tag team champions are simply two. That's Gino Hernandez, Jake the Snake Roberts, and Chris Adams. 5 minutes gone. It's Chris Adams and Kevin Von Erich will be doing battle here in our main event on World Class Championship Wrestling. Donovan and Akbar, and Akbar attacked on that left leg again. Donovan rips it out. Kick Donovan. Great physique. Works out Santa Monica, you know, the Muscle Beach boys. And he is an example of good physical training. Akbar with sort of a claw hole now on the midsection. He's got Donovan's attention right now. Kevin Von Erich and Chris Adams will be in the main event. There are no championships at hand in that one. But Kerry Von Erich, as you know, is the new American heavyweight champion. There's a count of two. Skander Akbar does have a claw hold on Chick Donovan. An abdominal claw hold, and Chick is trying to break his way out of this one. And does, with a couple of shots to the head. Donovan having a tough time with Skander Akbar, who certainly has proven himself. He may be a devious manager, a devious businessman in the use of human flesh, but he looks like he can handle himself. Whoa, look out here. A hammer across the apron, and that's tough on knees. Here comes Donovan. Well, he's trying to slide back in. We're going to give that knee another shot. Now around the pole. Well, he may be counted out if he doesn't get back in here in a hurry. Now Donovan's back. Akbar looking distressed as he comes up. Donovan working on the big guy, and he drops him. Head step over inside toehold on the left knee of Skander Akbar. Headed down on one shoulder. Now down, trying to get a count. Twisting an inside step over toe hold again. Donovan really wanted to put. Oh, here comes Khan. Here comes Khan in. And Killer Khan interferes. And the missiles fly as Khan interferes with Donovan. Skander Akbar. He's got to be the lawyer comes. Gordy. is taking care of Akbar and taking care of Khan. Remember that Texas death match last week, and now the boot's off. And there goes Skander. And there goes Khan. And Donovan is the winner thanks to the interference of Killer Khan. And here is Mark Lawrence with the decision.
8 minutes and 25 seconds. The winner of the bout, Chick Donovan.
Chick Donovan the winner thanks to the interference of Killer Khan. And there's the help that Donovan needed to get out of the tough situation, Terry Gordy. And we'll be back in a moment with more excitement on World Class Championship Wrestling.
This event, one fall, 60-minute time limit. This is for the American Tag Team title. First of all, the challengers on my left, from Memphis, Tennessee, also known as the PYTs. First of all, Mr. Coco Ware and Mr. Norvell Austin. And the current American Tag Team champions, from the City of Angels, the Fantastics. Your referee is Rick Hazard.
And the Fantastics sailing that hat out into the arena. A little souvenir for somebody at Reunion Arena as the Fantastics. Tommy Rogers and Bobby Fulton put their American Tag Team Championship on the line against the PYTs, Norvell Austin and Coco Ware. There are the championship belts. The PYTs, those pretty young things right there. Austin and Ware against the Fantastics. A couple of young men who have taken world-class championship wrestling by storm. Handsome, exciting, and tremendously qualified to be champions. Coco Ware and Norvell Austin. Bobby Fulton and Tommy Rogers ready to go. Got a little shake hands? Nope, guess not. Rick Hazard is the referee and we're ready to go. The PYTs, well, I guess you could call them pretty young things if you stretched it a bit. But this should be an interesting and exciting battle. And maybe a lot of surprises in this one. And I'd like to know what Sunshine Surprise is all about. Sunshine says she has a surprise. And with that young lady, anything really surprising the way she comes up with a way to turn things around and about. Whoa, a big miss right there. Well, the Fantastics defending their championship of the American Tag Team Championship. They're up against a couple of really tough customers in the PYT. Hard smash, and look at that shot. And Bobby Fulton is in agony and pain. And now his face of glowing red. He wants to get after it. And so they work on each other. Ah. Twisting wrist. Work it back. Oh, Fulton on his back. The PYT and the Fantastics getting it going. Remember, a great tradition of world-class championship wrestling, Christmas Star Wars. Bobby Fulton ready to go again. So Norvell comes in now for Coco Ware. Norvell Austin, maybe the unprettiest of the two. And Bobby Fulton. Twisted on that wrist. Bobby needs to get something going. He hasn't had that opportunity yet. Whoa, right on the back. Fulton, now they get after it. A headbutt from Fulton. Checked him to be sure he's okay. Big Norvell. There's a hand clasp, but no change. They just did a little high five on that one. It's a little different. You got to know the secret. What a contrast in styles and accompaniment. Look at Bobby Fulton battling. Coco's in there in the middle of it. And here comes Tommy. And now they have a poster. And it explodes all over the ring. A fantastic exploding. The count is on, but I don't think the referee can separate all this. Oh, up, up and over. Norvell landed on his face. Coco missed it. Here's the drop kick. And out go the PYTs. So Fulton and Rogers have cleared the ring. The Fantastics. Well, they're kind of getting things started their way now after Fulton had the slow start. It'll carry Von Erichs, the American heavyweight champion now, and I just got to believe that that's going to be awfully hard for Ric Flair to avoid the challenge. Ric Flair's been avoiding Kerry. Kerry wants to get back with him. And Kerry has that American championship. We'll look forward to that time when they do meet. Now, Coco to Norvell. Over a couple, over a couple. Look out, the traffic jam. Austin down and Coco. Great move by Bobby Fulton. Well, the PYTs take a look at each other like, what hit us? Freeway traffic is not much wilder than that. Don't forget, 5 minutes gone. Don't forget that World Class Championship Wrestling is coming to Abilene.
Shame on you, Coco
Ware. Abilene, the gateway to the West. And coming to World Class Championship Wrestling, the great Midnight Express. The manager, Jim Cornette. Oh, look out. A little extraneous. Fulton giving Coco a little bit of heckling over there. Now it's Austin. And Bobby. Now Rogers comes in for the first time. They diverted the attention of the referee and Tommy Rogers in. Not quite three, got that right shoulder up. These two tremendously conditioned young men look fantastic. Against two very tough and conditioned men, the PYTs. We've seen how tough they are. Tommy Rogers holding that headlock in. Holding it tough.
No, no, no.
Ooh, what a move. And tremendous collision. Up and over. Tommy Rogers taking that blow, taking it, coming right back to the side mirror move. Two and not quite three. Just got out of there. Rogers, even with a smile when he's being battered about. There goes Austin.
Ooh.
Well, that'll shake your brains up. Boy, those two collided up. Austin flies. And Fulton flies. And Rogers bashes. There's exchange. Fulton's in. And Hazard's trying to say, remember now, who was that? Bobby Rogers with a headlock. Hey, a lot of our great fans watch on KVEO TV channel 23 in Brownsville for the Rio Grande Valley. Hope you're watching World Class Championship Wrestling 2 in Brownsville. All up and down the valley. Headbutt by Bobby Fulton. Norvell's on his back and Fulton is on his head. Good move by Fulton. At the shoulder is a one and not a two. Fantastics and PYTs, a World Class Championship Wrestling. Sunshine would give us no hint of what her surprise might be, but I'm sure that young lady can is thinking of the future, and her work is still amazing. And Bobby Fulton is sort of directing his attention to Norvell Austin, and now Coco Ware is going to check in. And let's see if they can get it rolling. A PYT. Coco Ware doesn't like the crowd working that hard, but Bobby and Tommy certainly do. So the Fantastics have taken charge now as Coco Ware and Norvell Austin. We're in early, but Fulton is back, stops the blow, comes up, stops him again, and really unloads and smashes Coco Ware on top. One, two, but Fulton's kicked out of there with Coco Ware. Brings Tommy Rogers in, and Tommy hammers the arm, and Tommy is a wild man going after Coco Ware. But it's holiday time. Remember, it's World Class Championship Wrestling time, and we're looking forward to Christmas Star Wars, which has become a great tradition. You join us with World Class Championship Wrestling and Christmas Tradition. Tommy Rogers running through Norvell Austin. Oh, Coco got a handful of Rogers' hair. And now Norvell with a headbutt and a kick. And Rogers in trouble. And Rogers right down here in front of us. As Norvell brings it back in. All sorts of extracurricular work going on as Coco Ware and Bobby Fulton have at it. And now they got Tommy Rogers lashed out of this corner. Coco Ware down there on Tommy Rogers. Takes Bobby Fulton. Norvell's got Rogers in on Tommy's midsection. Hammering. Coco Ware hammering again. Coco Ware exploding all over Rogers. And the PYTs have taken charge. Backbreaker. Norvell Austin moving in. Boy, do they have this thing going now. There goes Tommy. And he's down again in Austin. Trying to put Tommy Rogers away. Take the Fantastic down. Here comes Coco Ware back in. Driving into the midsection. Rogers being pummeled and bashed and battered. Coco Ware having his fun. Exchange again with a headlock, and Bobby Fulton wants to come across. And a PYT. Aaron Rodgers. Carvel Austin looking things over. Seems to be comfortable with everything. Hammers him again. And the PYTs are close to victory here if they can keep up this pace. But Rodgers comes firing back. Rodgers fights back. Rodgers battles. Shaky, but coming back. Coco Ware needs some help. Carvel Austin trying to come in. Rodgers works free, and here comes Fulton. Fulton cleaning up the floor. Fulton hammering everybody and everything. A roll up. One, two, not three as Austin comes in. Off the ropes. He's got an abdominal stretch on Coco Ware. An abdominal stretch on Ware. Austin slamming Ware. And now Ware's roll. Austin's roll. One, two, three. The fantastic pull up.
Seconds, still the American Tag Team Champions, the Fantastics.
13 minutes and 50 seconds, the Fantastics retain their American Tag Team Championship as they're mobbed by their adoring fans, which may be tougher on them than the PYTs. But a tremendous finish, a great bout. And we'll be back with more World Class Championship Wrestling in just a moment. And let's go to Mark Lawrence in the ring.
Ladies and gentlemen, your next bout of the evening, a tag team event, one fall, 45-minute time limit. First in front of me, 240 pounds from Louisiana, Jake the Snake Roberts. And teaming with him from the provinces of Canada at 260 pounds, Kelly Kanitsky. And across the ring, their opponents, first from St. Louis, Missouri, 235 pounds, the Iceman, King Parsons. And teaming with him from Denton County, 260 pounds, the superstar and a former world heavyweight champion, Kerry Von Erich. Bronco Lubitsch, your referee.
Kerry Von Erich against Jake the Snake Roberts and Kelly Kanitsky. Those two working close together now, as Jake the Snake has kind of taken Kanitsky under his arm and is tutoring him, coaching him how to become a winner, how to become what Jake is. Maybe he's going to tutor him in his lifestyle and his philosophy, which will be quite interesting. Is it Jake is sort of just let it go, laissez-faire. The Snake is smooth and sometimes cruel, and he has that famous DDT clincher, one of the most devastating finishing holds in all of professional wrestling. And Jake the Snake Roberts hopping in there, coming up, trying to throw a few shots at Kerry Von Erich. A tag team event, our main event on World Class Championship Wrestling. Jake 240 pounds, Kerry 260. Kanitsky with an exchange, and Kanitsky is out running away. Jake the Snake, a little heated up over Kerry Von Erich. Kanitsky! Being imitated by Kerry Von Erich. And Kerry ruled in. Kerry so quick. Here comes the Iceman. And the Iceman working on Kaniski. And right back is Kaniski. Gets him rolling on the wrist lock. Comes his roll back. Great reverse kick. Great reverse kick for Iceman King Parsons. And the Iceman. Broken it. Trying to get a wrist lock going here. Jake the Snake now working against Iceman. Oh, there he goes. It might be a nope. Jake the Snake is hard to pull down because of the long legs. High center of gravity. And he is tough. Here comes Kaniski back now. Backbreaker and Kaniski on top of the chance new. Iceman kicks him right out. Rolls it over, puts it on a reverse chin. Now Kerry Von Erich awaits in the corner. Kaniski and Roberts exchanging it, and they got it going. And they've got it going very well. Jake the Snake Roberts. One of the six-man world tag team champions. He and Chris Adams and Gene Ryan. Oh, what a shot of Kaniski. They're standing by there. But Jake the Snake is riding on top. Reverse 10. Kerry Von Erich trying to help his friend along. Yellow's going to come over and help him. Don't forget, we're not far away from Christmas Star Wars, a great, great world class championship tradition. And a tremendous throng over 20,000 in the Union Arena. Is he going to make it? No. Hold on, that headlock is Jake the Snake Roberts. Rocco Lubitsch checking. Rocco Lubitsch. But no way. Jake the Snake continues to put that pressure on Iceman King Parsons. Picks up the cry of go Ice, go. And Ice is going. And runs right through. And Iceman gets a knee into the lower midsection. And Jake the Snake is ready for his knee double chop. Kaniski coming off. Jake slithers down like a rattler and puts his grasp on Iceman as Kaniski clotheslines Iceman. Kaniski, the Canadian, son of the great Gene Kaniski, former world champion. A neck breaker by Kaniski. Kaniski want to go in with a knee drop across the neck. One. Ooh, but Iceman pulls it up. Iceman tough to handle. Kaniski and Roberts have got it going right now in the corner. 5 minutes gone in this bout. So Kaniski getting some suggestions for Jake the Snake. Fires in, here comes the Iceman. A miss by Kaniski. Oh, what a left kick by Iceman. A chop. And Jake the Snake comes in, and all mayhem breaks loose. Everybody's after him. There goes Ice over the top rope. And now they got Kerry Von Erich, Kaniski, and Jake the Snake. Pounded away on Kerry. And Kerry handles one and the other. It's a fisticuff center right now. But here's a roll up by Iceman. Two, three, Iceman beats Kaniski. Iceman gets Kaniski, and Kerry Von Erich and Iceman are the winners. There they are, the winners. And here's Mark Lorenz.
2 minutes and 2 seconds, the winners in the ring, Iceman and Kerry.
Iceman Keith Parsons and Kerry Von Erich overcoming adversity. Well, Jake the Snake and Kaniski, Texas best. And we'll be back with more excitement and information on World Class Championship Wrestling.
This is a special challenge match, one fall, 30-minute time limit. First of all, on my left, the reigning Texas heavyweight champion from Highland Park, Texas, weighing 240 pounds, Gino Hernandez. He is assisted by his bodyguard, Andrea the Lady Giant. And his challenger behind me here, from Denton, Texas, weighing 220 pounds, Mike Von Erich. Your referee is Bronco Lubitsch.
Mike Von Erich. And Gino Hernandez, the Texas heavyweight champion, on the championship bout. Gino, open it up before the bell can ring. And now the bell does ring, but Mike is caught off guard, and Gino drives and misses as Mike Von Erich comes right back now and works on the champion. It's a non-title bout, but you may recall it was Mike Von Erich who upset Gino and won the American Championship from him. That's when Gino was worried about Stella Mae Fritz making her appearances, and he thought she was there, and she wasn't. And Mike Von Erich, young in the ring, but certainly not without that great Von Erich spirit, and he defeated Gino Hernandez. Well, now, Kerry Von Erich has taken back the American Championship. Gino still has that Texas Championship and is coveted by the Von Erichs. And Gino, along with Jake the Snake Roberts and Chris Adams, are the six-man World Tag Team Champions. Gino goes out, Gino comes in, thanks to Mike Von Erich and Andrea. Nicola Roberts, Andrea the Lady Giant, watching from the side. Bronco Lubitsch, the referee, is Mike Von Erich. And Gino Hernandez square off. It is Thanksgiving, the holiday Star Wars of Reunion Arena. And we're looking forward to Christmas Star Wars and a great tradition of world-class championship wrestling. And right now, Mike Von Erich catching that knee to the midsection has his own problems. Tremendous bounce in world class. The Link beating Zumhoff. Terry Gordy coming through in the Texas Deathmatch. Knock off Khan, and Mike Von Erich is trying to, I guess you'd have to say, upset Gino Hernandez, since he is a champion a couple of times. Gino missing with a wild right as Mike Von Erich really stays after him. Marco Lovitch coming in to tell Gino to not turn his back on him, but Gino did that as a ploy, and now Mike is caught, and Mike is hammered. Gino Hernandez, the driving elbow, and Mike Von Erich shaking up. Mike Von Erich and Gino Hernandez. Oh, Gino puts Mike down with a suplex. And now Gino's going to try to put him away. A high fly. He missed it. Grabbed his elbow and shoulder. And Mike Von Erich comes back. Mike made a great move so that Gino crashed into the deck. Gino hammered, shaken, battered by Mike Von Erich. And it'll take him around the ring. Find all four corners of the compass. The wrestling compass. And it'll try to get into that other one, but nope. Gino's gonna fly into Bronco. and Lovitch is down, shaken and battered. Mike Rutter hammering Jeter Hernandez. A sleep hold. Mike Rutter into the sleep hold. Gino backing up now. Andrea steps in. And Andrea catches a knee to the head. Mike made a great move. Andrea caught a knee to the side of the head. Bronco is slowly getting up. Mike Von Erich comes off. Tito goes down. Mike Von Erich up. Andrea got up. Gino. The driving elbow into the midsection. One, two, three. Mike got his leg up. Andrea interfering, but Bronco Lovitch shaking, never saw it. But Gino Hernandez proclaimed the winner in a bout that has got to go down as a great robbery to Mike Von Erich. Now here comes David Manningham, who is watching in the back, a closed circuit. And Bronco Lovitch talking about Andrea, David Manning. Mike Von Erich the winner. Mike Von Erich, and here's a war. Mike Von Erich and Gino exploding. And Gino escapes, but Mike Von Erich is the winner. Well, that's excitement. The kind of excitement you're going to see in Amarillo tomorrow on KJTV Channel 14 in Amarillo. Watch for all this and watch for World Class Championship Wrestling. And let's take a break as World Class Championship Wrestling will continue with our main event in just a moment. Of his brother in the background. And here's a Texas death match where it just lets everything go. It just starts. You know, there might be a fall, but
this bout, ladies and gentlemen, here's Mark, a Texas death bout, no time limit. Falls do not count. Wrestler will be given a 30-second rest period after each fall. The bout will continue until someone cannot answer a 10 count after the rest period. Kerry Von Erich is the special referee. The combatants are, from Atlanta, Georgia, 270 pounds, Fabulous Freebird, Terry Gordy. And from Mongolia, 240 pounds, Killer Khan. Killer. General Akbar is managing at ringside.
Killer Khan and Terry Gordy in this Texas death match where anything and everything goes. The special referee, Kerry Von Erich, on hand just to be sure that, well, they don't take it so far that somebody's got to be carted out of here. But that's just about the way a Texas death match is handled. And you may recall that Fritz Von Erich never lost a Texas death match in his illustrious career. Khan fighting in on Terry Gordy, the Fabulous Freebird. Kerry Von Erich set up as a special referee because you got to have somebody about the strength and size and agility when it's necessary to handle these guys. Oh, there's a shot right on the choppers of the Khan, who looms over our table right here. And loom is probably the best word. Now it is Gordy biting back on Khan. One bite good for another bite as these two. Crash. Terry Gordy wanting revenge on Devastation Incorporated. Gordy, who has made his new career in getting Skander Akbar's Devastation Incorporated, starting with Khan, who's shaken and weary and groggy as he peers around, and Gordy goes after him. Yes, the Fabulous Freebirds, a great team. We got a great new team coming in too. The exciting Midnight Express, and there goes Gordy onto the floor of Reunion Arena. Exciting Midnight Express. And they're managed by another exciting individual, Jim Corbett. Jim Cornett. And in the ring right now, Kerry Von Erich and Khan face to face. Gordy is coming alive after battering into that corner post. Now Khan wants to go get him, and now blood trickling down the nose of Terry Gordy. And Khan smells the chance to go to work again. A Texas death match. Falls don't count. If there is a fall, there's 30 seconds respite. And then if the wrestler can't continue, the bout's over. Kerry, by the way, the special referee, is the new American heavyweight champion. Oh, Gordy is becoming a red pulpy mess out there. And with Kerry becoming the American heavyweight champion, it would appear that Ric Flair is going to have a harder time than ever avoiding a rematch with Kerry Von Erich. Khan tearing into a bleeding Terry Gordy. His face a roadmap of red lines. Gordy in trouble as Khan smells a chance to win this one. Gordy, who has made it his caveat now to go after Devastation Incorporated, and here is Khan in the corner. Khan down with a knee across the neck. Khan down with a one, two, and three, and a battered Terry Gordy is beaten by Terry, by Killer Khan. We will have a 30-second delay now. And if Gordy cannot answer, then it is Khan's bout. But the falls do not count. They can go 10 falls, 20 falls, as long as they can come back after 30 seconds. And while Khan and Kerry Von Erich are nose to nose, and Akbar looks like he wants to get into... We're going back now and take a little look at this as Gordy's still on the mat. Now watch Khan come off the rope. 30 seconds here. Terry Gordy bleeding profusely. Once the 30 seconds are up, then he must be able to go back into action by a 10 count. And right now he's got to worry about getting back. 30 seconds have passed, and now the count is on by Kerry Von Erich. And he's up and ready to go again. So Khan goes back to work. Gordy made it up. But Gordy looks to be in almost impossible situation as Khan goes back. Oh, this is really a fierce situation now with Khan. But Gordy fights back. Gordy absolutely covered in this death match, Texas style. There goes Khan out. Terry Gordy. Meeting Khan again as Khan comes back to the corner. Khan takes him into the corner. But no, it is Khan in the corner. Into the post, and Khan is battered. Into the corner post. And Terry Gordy commands the center of the ring. And now Khan has a cut on the forehead. Khan slashed his head open as he battered into the corner post. Kerry Von Erich warning Gordy to stay away while Khan tries to regain his composure. And while we have a second to remind you too about another great newcomer coming in, a tremendous man from the great Northwest, Billy Jack. This man is just legendary in wrestling circles. Billy Jack's his name. Here comes Killer Khan back. Both men bleeding profusely now from head wounds. Clothesline by Terry Gordy. Cowan is flat on his back, and Gordy trying to pick up the tempo now as he came back from near disaster. Huge drop. Out on his head. Cowan slithers back. Gordy's on top. 2, 3, and Gordy has come back for the second fall here. Now it's up to Cowan to try to come around in 30 seconds and then be up and ready to go in 10. 30 seconds for Cowan to try to get back as Terry Gordy, who looked like he was through, came off the map, revitalized himself. Here we go back to the change as Terry Gordy picks that huge 270-pounder up and drops him on his head. And Cowan already battered into the corner post, is put down for the count of three. Thanksgiving Holiday Wrestling Star Wars. Well, we're right here in Reunion Arena. Remind you that Christmas Star Wars, another great tradition, will be coming up too. Pick up the count with the fans. He's got to be up. He made it. A Cowan straddle out. Cowan. Also a bloody pulp. Terry Gordy. They wouldn't recognize him now. This is a war. They look like two spear carriers here. Genghis Khan's army. Brutalizing the countryside. But instead, it's Gordy brutalizing the Mongolian. 1, 2, and not quite enough for 3. Khan with a reflex action. Gordy, who has his campaign to destroy Skander Ekbar and Devastation Incorporated, but now Khan covered in his own human qualities, trying to come back. Drops across Gordy, and Gordy is losing out again. Gordy lost the first fall. Khan won, lost the second. Here's a chance for the third, 2, and just enough up to get the shoulders up as Skander Ekbar, the general, pats him out to my left. What a fantastic card here. What a fantastic battle, these two huge giants. Khan trying to pull Gordy up. Gordy won't go. A struggle. Two huge men grasping, grappling for life. Struggling toward eternity. Working, driving. Almost to death wish and a suplex, and the huge Mongolian smashes on the mat. And the man from Atlanta, Georgia, the fabulous Freebird of Michael Hayes, comes over to put a pin on him. 1, 2, and no, he got the right shoulder up. No. Harry Von Erich, the special referee, waving off that third slap of the hand as the Gordy comes up again. And Khan. These two, like Roman gladiators, battling in the Colosseum. And the Khan misses and jams his knees. And it's the Oriental Spike that Khan taught, or took to the man who could teach, Terry Gordy, when these two were friends. And there it is, the Oriental Spike in the neck of Khan. And Khan turning on his friend, going to Devastation Incorporated. Terry Gordy, a humble man who does not believe in turning on his friends, has now got seeking revenge, seeking restitution. And now it is Khan slowly slowly drying up in his energy as Gordy keeps the Oriental Spike dug into the jugular vein. While both men see their lifeblood oozing slowly. Barry Von Erich warning Skander Akbar to stay farther away. It takes a while to put a man of nearly 300 pounds to sleep. And Gordy's hanging on, and Khan, one, two, and three. And Gordy wants to stay with this to put Khan totally away. And Kerry Von Erich has not pulled him out of there yet. And now he is. Kerry trying to pull Gordy up. So Kerry Von Erich moving in, waited for Gordy to give up on the Oriental Spike, and he didn't do it, had to pull him out of there. And Khan lying on the mat, trying to get his breath back, trying to get his blood flowing again into his system. Trying to get up in 30 seconds, and then a count of 10. As a Texas death match, and this one certainly appropriately, there's the 30 seconds, and here's a count. Now listen to the crowd count. And Kerry Von Erich, meeting Skander Akbar, who tried to come in. And the winner, here comes Missing Link. And the Link hitting Gordy from behind. And now Kerry Von Erich has a battle. As if Gordy's entered in the court of the Link, battering against Kerry Von Erich. Kerry and the Link, and Khan is up, and now it's going to be a war with the referee, the special referee. And here comes Gordy. And here comes Khan. Out on the table. Link. Kerry. Gordy. Khan's on the floor here beside us. And now Gordy and the Link square off. And it is Gordy who squares away and clears the ring with the help of Kerry Von Erich. That is sort of the victory celebration. And now, Kerry Von Erich meeting the Link with a chair, and the Link is gone. And the Link trying to find somebody to crash into, and here comes Khan back. But I think Kerry and Gordy have pretty well cleared it out now, although Khan is still making some effort. Now Khan coming back. Skander Akbar waiting for them. Missing Link right here. Looking as though he wants another bit of it, but it has been Terry Gordy and Kerry Von Erich who have cleared the ring. Now these two of Devastation Incorporated, and now Kerry Von Erich has something to say.
Akbar, you finished the match at the seven count. In my opinion, referee's opinion, Khan would have been down the full 10 seconds. Terry Gordy is the winner.
Kerry Von Erich raising the hand of Terry Gordy in triumph. A battered, a bleeding, a maimed Terry Gordy, the winner. And look here, Kerry Von Erich sticking out his hand, but Gordy just looks with a question. They're vast, long time, old enemies of Von Erich's and the Freebirds. And the Freebird says, no way. And Kerry Von Erich walks away. And the crowd reacts. A nice gesture on the part of Kerry Von Erich. A nice gesture as Kerry leaves the arena, and Terry Gordy looks at him. There goes Kerry, the special referee. Well, Kerry, Terry's
coming. Hey, Von Erich!
Terry's coming
over here. You gotta get to know, boy, you're playing your
heart in
this ring.
Uh-oh. I think we've got the old nemesis, the war between the Von Erichs and the Freebirds. Looks like they're ready to go after it as Gordy. Gordy sticks out his head and clinches it. What a turn of events! I thought Terry Gordy was going to tear into Kerry Von Erich with Terry. Terry Bam Bam Gordy. Sticks out his hand in friendship and fellowship with his former old nemesis, Kerry Von Erich. And we'll be back with more excitement of World Class Championship Wrestling in just a moment. Before this main event, we had an opportunity to talk to Kevin Von Erich and Chris Adams. Here's our interview first with Kevin. Right here with Kevin Von Erich just before his bout with Chris Adams. This is the time, the one you've been looking for.
Well, Bill, I made all these people a promise, so I'm going to hold up to it. Folks, you're never going to see a match like you're going to see here in just a minute. This is, you could say this is kind of going to be Kev at his best and Kev at his worst. You be your own judge, but I made you a promise. What Chris Adams did to me, I'm not going to let it go. I've told you, he's going to leave this building the same way I left the Cotton Bowl. I'm going to hold to that.
So winning is important, but you want to really lay him out.
Well, yeah, okay, winning's kind of important, but I told you, I've got a mission here tonight. I'm not going to call it revenge. I'm going to call it justice.
We're going to talk to Chris in a moment. You want to say anything to him?
I'll do my talking in the ring.
Thanks, Kevin. Good luck.
Thank you.
That was Kevin Von Erich. And now in the dressing room with his mentor and manager, Gary Hart, we turn our attention to the Englishman, Chris Adams. Chris Adams, Kevin Von Erich says he's going to send you out of the ring just the same way you sent him out at the Cotton Bowl.
Listen, Bill, idle threats do not worry me.
Idle?
Idle threats do not worry me. All I'm interested in is 1, 2, 3 in the middle of the ring. And then when I get that, I'll show everybody that I can beat him, as I did in the Cotton Bowl. Did you see the Cotton Bowl?
I saw the Cotton Bowl.
Did you see my shoulder up? Did you see my shoulder up when
it was close, yes.
The Texas referee counted? All I'm interested in is a 1, 2, 3, Bill, and when I get that, if he wants any rough stuff, that's okay with me, because everybody saw how he went out last time.
Are you threatening him now?
I'm not threatening him. What I'm saying is, it could happen again.
We shall see. Chris Adams. Kevin Von Erich from Denton County. And it's off and running. I'm not sure we'll even get this one officially started because the war is on. Gonna ring the bell. Chris Adams in our lap here as Kevin Von Erich tossed him out. And I'm trying to put my area back together as Chris tried to put his area back together, and these two are at a war. These two are at the height of a conflict.
Revenge bout, London, England, 235 pounds. Chris Adams
attacking Chris Adams
versus from Denton County, 240 pounds. Kevin Von Erich. Playboy manager Gary Hart in ringside.
What a shot. Gary Hart just sitting over to my left. And I keep an eye on Gary to see what he's planning. There goes Chris. And Chris hops out right into the camera. This is something. Oh, Kevin Von Erich, red-faced, tense. Top, coil like a panther, promising something that may be very difficult to do, and that's to lay Chris Adams out. Kevin was laid out so much that we had to call up for medical aid. And I'm sure Chris is remembering that and has been thinking about that prior to this bout. Though he seemed very, oh, a shot right across the face. Chris on the run. Chris Adams on the run, but he grabs next Kevin as he comes in. Look out, here he comes again on our table. And now the war is on right here. We shall See if we can move out of the way a bit as these two battle and slam each other. Right here on the media area. Now the conflict goes back to the ring. Kevin and Chris Adams. Kevin and Chris Adams battling. Once, first it's Chris, then it's Kevin. Now it's Chris again. We've got a little audio problem over here, and you can imagine that because of the two wrestlers falling into our area. They're having a little problem with the microphone. We'll try to keep this going as we roll along here with this fantastic battle. Gary Hart is staying over out of the way right now. Here comes Chris into the corner. Chris, Gary Hart grabbing Chris Adams' trunks to protect him from blowing out with Kevin. Now Chris is up 1, 2, and 3. Chris Adams beating Kevin Von Erich, but he had the trunks, and Kevin is working out now to Gary Hart. Kevin has a wooden chair here. Uh-oh, wooden chairs. And Kevin with a microphone. Kevin has picked
up. I made these people a promise, and I'm holding to it, baby.
Here comes Gary Hart, gets slammed on the head into the corner. Buckley, here comes Kevin in. Now Chris has the chair, and he and David Manning. Kevin drop kicking Chris. Kevin with the chair again. Now Manning is trying to stop him. Chris knows what's in store for him, and over his head now goes Chris. Kevin smashing Chris with a chair. Here comes Hart in, and Hart has hit. Hart has something in his handkerchief. He's decked. Oh, Chris is smashed again. Kevin Dunn has broken the chair over Chris's head. Chris has a gash on his head, and Kevin is now doing the same to Chris as Chris did to the cotton bowl. And they're going to have to pull Kevin off. Chris is in danger right now. Kevin has gone absolutely wild. Here comes Hazard in. Adams flattened. Two blows to the head. Gary Hart flattened. And Chris bleeding from his attack by Kevin Von Erich, who's being pushed away. Chris smash on the head. We've got to move aside as Chris comes out now. Gary Hart trying to help Chris. Kevin Von Erich got his revenge. Kevin got his revenge. Chris is being helped from the arena, dragged out here just beside us. There goes Chris Adams out. Kevin Von Erich, true to his word, breaking the chair apart over Chris Adams and Gary Hart. Chris Adams being helped from the arena. Again, we apologize for the breakup of our audio, but you know, with the violence that occurred here and flying into all our equipment, we lost some of that. But we certainly didn't lose the intensity and the...
Hey, this match ain't over. That ain't good enough. I said a stretcher.
Kevin Von Erich urging Chris to come back to put him on a stretcher.
Four minutes, 25 seconds is the time.
And undoubtedly, even though Kevin Von Erich was the loser, he was the winner. We'll be back with more World Class Championship Wrestling in a moment.